When I was interviewing for medical school, I learned that Case Western Reserve was introducing a new progressive program using the Microsoft HoloLens to teach anatomy. It definitely factored into my decision making.
We've developed a digital representation of both the male and female body. You can easily see details that a medical student needs to know.
I didn't think that any sort of technology could come close to what we're doing now in our cadaver lab.
It was pretty incredible. The way I've been describing it to people who haven't worn the lens yet is kind of like in Star Wars when Princess Leia just like pops up in front of them. Now this human body is just standing right next to you.
You could hear people like in awe and then just saying, like, this is so cool.
And what the HoloLens allows you to do is see structures that would be really difficult to see in a cadaver.
Like the lymphatics, like the ductal system.
And I still don't really know what a lymph node looks like in a cadaver. We can't see any of it.
You'd certainly waste a lot less time dissecting things.
And for medical students who don't have that much time, it's very important to be efficient about their learning.
Look at the less.
We've done over a dozen trials that have shown positive student outcomes. Students are learning faster, and it looks like they may even be retaining knowledge better.
When I'm doing like my third year clinical rotations, it's been really helpful for me just because I could visualize it how I did in the HoloLens, and it sticks in our brain.
We're taking this to the next level and adding animation and physiology. We're currently working with new partner schools so that more students can benefit. We also knew that every school teaches anatomy a little bit differently. So we've made tools that allow you to customize the HoloAnatomy content to fit your needs.
HoloLens is able to distill something complicated and visualize it the way it actually is in a human body and retain that information. I hope more people end up jumping on board.